Hello guys and welcome to The Opera Room. My name is Pascal and of course you know The Opera Room brings you everyone and of course all the amazing celebrities and your thought leaders that you always love to see. Today's none other as of course we have here a brother, all right, from another mother, from the same place. But we'll go to a short break before I introduce him. When we return, The Opera Room continues with a big fish. Welcome back guys, it's still The Opera Room. I'm right here. It's time to unleash, all right, and unveil the person that we have here for you today that we're going to be talking about different things with. He's a comedian, he's an actor, is I don't know, maybe he wanted to go into politics, but I don't know what party he belonged to. But meanwhile, we're talking about none other than Prince Ode Ajiri, Princewill. All
right. You don't put that wheel. That yeah, will
prince,
is very
the
important.
The prince first now. You're a prince. You know, prince.
You see, the prince, he took plenty. But you see, Prince Will is exceptional.
Prince just, Will.
And I'm the most popular Prince Will in the world.
For so, real?
Yes, now.
That's it.
I got 1 billion with me. If I get 1 billion, I'll have for you.
But how are you doing, though? How are you doing? Thank you so much for coming.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for
coming. I'm doing the best we can do in Nigeria.
Yeah, from the south part of Nigeria, there's a particular thing that worry joke or south joke, that is sweet past. Do you believe?
Of course now, comedy started from worry now. So comedy actually started from the people of Delta State.
For real?
Yeah.
Is this empirically proven?
Or yeah, so I'll give you the history. When the white men started coming to Nigeria for the first time, they picked black slaves, you know. So when the black slaves went out, after work during the day, they gathered in the evening and they started throwing jabs, what we call yabis.
Oh, okay.
That is the character of the Urhobo people. So as time goes on, it became popular. And the masters noticed that their white friends are coming to watch these guys do this service. So they started collecting gate fee. So
for real?
Yes. So when comedy started worldwide, initially, the white guys who wanted to copy the black guys would paint their face black to do what we call today stand-up comedy. It is an African thing, a Delta thing, and a Urhobo thing. We started stand-up comedy in the world.
So it's just effortlessly for a Delta man or a Urhobo man or a Soko man to just do comedy.
So yes, when I came to Lagos, I didn't plan being a comedian. This thing I do is by mistake. And so when
for
I was
real?
So when I was a bus conductor, I play with my passengers.
Hmm?
And that's the part people like to hear sometimes. I play with my passengers and they'll say, wait till you they do for yeah. You they waste your time. It was passengers that told me I could be a comedian.
For real? So you were a bus conductor?
As a bus conductor for 11 years. I came to Lagos now at 5. Okay, not up to 11. Actively as a bus conductor for 7 years. 2005 to 2012. At 2012, my Night of Thousand Laugh performance that I did in 2010 was already selling on CDs. So people were already starting to notice my face, so I had to stop. Stopping bus conducting at the time was not even profitable. Look at the cash out now. You don't understand. If you do one trip, from Ikeja to Oju Elegba, that I would carry Oju Elegba 100 naira, Pango Onigba 70, Maryland was 50. If you run four
trips. You know. Wow.
If you run four trips in the evening, we really don't work for morning. So we work just in the evening. We don't want go come in the morning. And they call that trip. English not trip. I want a go come. So you don't want go come in the morning. Then you do four in the evening. When you do that, then you make up to, as a bus conductor, 34,000 naira a day.
Wow, minus so, food money, you go use child.
No, you go eat as you work now. That was not hard now. So that was your pack. You understand. But normally you do like 34,000 a day. The only problem is that you know if you work every day. Because the day VI will cash you, last month will cash you, police go spoil, work, motor go spoil. So give and take, if you have 15 good days in a month, we're talking of about 60,000 naira. 60,000 at the time. I'm talking of far back 2010.
It was
60,000 naira at the time was about dollar was around 160.
Yes, 150.
$100 was 15,000. We're talking about $400. Today's world, we're talking about 600,000 naira.
Firstly, it shows two things. Number one, how things have spoiled. Number two, how far you've come. But meanwhile, thank God for how far you've come and where you are at this present moment. Do you sometimes remember and just reminisce and tear about your
every
story
time. Every time. So I posted a video on Instagram recently talking about how far I'd come. There was a time I had a drought in my life around 2020 after COVID. We had put all our eggs in the basket of comedy. You know, we believe see the events where they come. So when COVID come, we didn't work for about 8 months. So I had a lot of UBC debts here and there, and I had a quick notice. I had to move from my estate and go outside the estate. Now, this was an estate I moved into as a big boy, furnish house afresh, drive motor. But now I'm moving out and I don't even get car again. In fact, I use shame, struggle gates, like when they go buy something, they take bike, they go my new house. So I was crying, you know. But then it was like a voice was talking to me. Where I stay when I be bus conductor, not far from my present estate now. Now 100 naira keke. So I lived at Alakpereke to Paco bus stop, Salami Giwa Street number 2. So I just went back there and I did a video of my present house. This new house when I did cry about, so now brand new 2-bedroom home. Like brand new as the first place to rent it. So I went back to my former compound. Yeah, we were 7 people in one room. When we are about 100 people in the compound and we had just 1 bedroom and 1 toilet. And it dawned on me that if you are not stupid, you left here to here and you are complaining that things are going bad. You know, but what I was thinking in my head is that how can I be leaving Magodo Estates? As a big boy, and I'm going back. But then, just reminisce sometimes, and you realize that you've gone very far, and God has been good.
I like that. But let's talk about what you've been on recently, right now. Meanwhile, the what you just talked about right now is in my head. I'm just playing different pictures. Firstly, the psychological effect is gonna have on you, or that thing's gonna have on you. How you turned, how you will get to see that some of your friends are leaving you. Did you ever experience those things?
Of course. You just broke Sumo, you go no. People will tell you things that you never believed they were thinking about before. Somebody told me I could not pay my bills. I mean, when they buy drink for. Oh, look at that. Three times this guy don't buy drink for. Don't be saying they drink alcohol. If they drink the butter Guinness and Schweppes, he pay 3 times. So, and I sit down with these guys every day so that we don't really think me this. I just go back, I just say that if I don't get money, I know they come out in kid.
Hey, my God. My God.
It's a sweet process when you have sweet stories to
Absolutely.
Tell.
Absolutely. It's great to see. But quick definition of friends and acquaintance. What's different for your perspective?
Okay, so sometimes we mistake the two. In fact, we mistake more than the two. We mistake colleagues for friends. We mistake acquaintance for friends. We mistake church members for friends. Your friend, right? Let me put it. When I say you in this conversation, I don't mean you. If they kidnap you in the next 1 week, how many people will really notice that you are missing? Have you thought about
it?
There are people that you only hang out and drink with. They don't see you for 2 weeks. The day that, yeah, my guy! And you, the teaser, that your guy, not be your guy, and I just drink. You understand? There was one of my colleague that lost his wife at the time, and the family of the wife were ready to fight him. They accused him for everything wrong. And he was arrested in Banti. Two of our friends brought out their house rent to fight this case. We lodged beside Banti for the 2 weeks we fought the whole battle out. Make sure the autopsy was like they bring their house rent. How many people can really do it for you? If you find yourself in that setting today, when people need to drop their house rent to fight your battle, how many people can really get up? You know, if you broke. You can always see who will give you 100,000 or 50,000, depending on who you really be.
Yes.
But now Pokemon, they figure, and that Pokemon, it gets time frame. If they help you 2 times, and you not pick up. So, how many people can stand for you for 2 years, 3 years?
I still believe in the
course. I still believe that this guy will pick up, he's our guy, we owe him this. Those are your friends.
Amazing. So, when this thing happened to you, I just want you to tell me, like, a few of your comedian friends that. Alright, when this thing happened to you and you feel like, man, Omar, is the world capsizing over my head? Alright, or is my world crumbling? Who are those two comedians that you can't forget that were always with you, always in contact? Princewill, how far? How you did? You don't chop. You did come out. Come more ball. No think. Everything will do alright.
I didn't have two. I only had one. Now, that one, funny enough, how life happens, me and myself will not stay even that close again today.
For real?
Yeah, so the... And I don't blame him for it. The crisis that happened at the time overwhelmed him. And you know, everybody has their threshold. Even your upper way born, you get where you go, you go say you hold out too much. You know, so when you find yourself in situations like that, you are not only fighting finance, you are fighting emotions, you are fighting reactions. So now money they do you, but you go everything will spoil. You go they shout anyhow for house, they shout for outside, they quarrel with this person, they do this. And all this was boiling down on just the one friend I had at the time, but it was there. Mekoyo Collins, he was there. even though we're not too, these days we just see, we just heal, you know. Mm-hmm. And I have my reservations about him, where I decided to just step outside. I felt our relationship had been damaged too much. I don't know how long it will take to heal. So I just decided to step aside, but it does not change the fact that that one year, the guy dig out.
If the guy were so available for you, the time that you started having your relationship, didn't you think about the formal things or the formal relationship that you guys had to try to cushion what you guys currently have?
So, in the Bible, the story between Abraham and Lot, they were not fighting. But God told this guy, go like this, you go like this. Because at that point in time, that's the best way your relationship can stand. Mm. You know, understand? No, even your wife, when you get married for house, you get some kind things when you go, when you go find out, or some kind of things you go not transpire for now, you go look at something and say, be like, say this family go Europe, from out in Nigeria, maybe another one walk. So that's the place we found ourselves. Some things transpire, some words were said, and once a bottle is broken, it's always a bit hard.
As this thing is, you know, Urubu men, I understand something about them. So one thing you don't like to take is betrayal. Do you feel like it was betrayal?
Yeah. So yes, at a point I felt betrayed. The betrayal might not have come pre-planned. Mm-hmm. Yeah, like I said, the pressures of the time overwhelmed him at a point in time, but I still felt betrayed. I'll give you an example.
Go ahead.
So at the point in time, there was this side hustle I do. There's this, my mom belongs to an association in the market that give loans to women, to people, you know. So because my mom did the association, if me, I collect, I know they pay interest. Because that time I needed, even when I was moving to my new house, I pulled total money from them. You know, about 1.7 million. And I say, I know if you pay in 1 year, I would pay 50,000 anytime I get. So I had some friends who know that my mom is in this association. So they tell me, I'm always secure like 200K from mom, so I'm always pay the interest. Now, I give them the money, they start paying the interest, I start forwarding to mom. But me, they look and say, oh boy, this interest is too much. So this 200K with the guy borrow, now when me get 100K, I'll call pay. So that way that guy bring the interest, I'll come on my own small thing. Don't forget, not friends. These are just people that maybe would.
I understand. Everybody now.
Now the person who knows these details, is this my guy? Now I have to tell.
How the matter go, you know.
They pay me and I get problem. Woo! The first thing he did was call one of those guys. In the name of gist. And see what he prince with it. When the guy tell me now, I say, so what he consigned this quarrel, me and this guy?
I didn't link.
You understand? Mm. So those kind of things happen like 2-3 times. And I just say, you know what? It's fine.
I understand. One way or the other, everybody has been betrayed by people that we think like we really loved. All right, but it is what it is. Life. You understand, my brother. Anyways, let's talk about what you've been doing recently now. What is Princewill doing recently? What have you been doing? What have you been up to recently?
So a lot of things. I've come to realize that media has plenty of money.
So
I've been doing what you're doing, yeah. So I do political analysis online. I have a Facebook page that has about 300 and something thousand followers. So I have a YouTube page where they help me once. And then I've been into movie productions.
Fantastic.
Yeah, so I have another page for my movie production, Prinash Studios. So we set up that page for movie production. Then on News Matters with Princewill, I do my political analysis.
I like that. So let's talk about if no be God moment. You understand? You know, that's like a phrase. If no be God, if no be God, this particular thing no go happen. If no be God, this money where I get, this contract where I get, no go happen. You understand? That last minute miracle that you realized that, man, it was all God all through. It's been God all through. Tell me about it.
You know that sometimes people will come and start lying to you and tell you are very intelligent and smart. And if you are stupid enough, you will believe it's true. And I will not tell you, we're not smart. All of us just get luck. And God has just come true. Yeah, sometimes you put in the work and God keeps making it grow. The Bible says Paul planted and Apollos watered, but God keeps making it grow. When we were coming up as a comedian, and I was the least of my brothers, I was the one that if they say, may you tick people, we're not going to pass 2 years for this industry. Mm-hmm. My stubborn head and my anogu cree. A lot of factors represented the ideology that people had that are not go past 2 years. But you know, God has been faithful. There was a time in Maker Smith's house, 2008-2009, we have about 10 living with him. Amongst that 10, I was the problem of the house. Because I get one problem, eh? If everybody wakago like this, I don't believe say this side where they wakago something there. And you know, typically when you see that this is the way and somebody's going there, it's just natural for you to understand that this guy good mm-hmm. loss. But I'm not really lost somehow, so I know that God has always rescued me. Bro, you know I take on Lagos.
Tell me.
Hey, I just carry money at the age of 15, enter a salary bus at the go Lagos.
Which way?
Now be this Lagos guy you do. So if not be good, that will want to issue. Now be the Lagos. I don't have a family member in Lagos. I've never been to Lagos before. I've never seen Lagos.
For real?
I just enter bus at the go Lagos. Then they find me for us. The first person that saw me at Oshodi when I was selling pure water, when he went back to tell my mother that he saw me, this thing happened in 2005. 2005 till now is 19 years. Now last year, my mama believed, saying, no, that person came wrong.
Oh! So your mother thought maybe it was the person...
Oh, this story, you know, add up. The guy is saying, they Oshodi, he see me for, he didn't say, he see me sell pure water. Now he hold me, say, I must follow and go, well, you are not grill. People where did they call intervene, people they sell for that place where the barracks bust up is not also the where that cantonment there were shops there at that time selling clothes, all those shops when people wouldn't shop because shit go later in the evening. One of those guys call intervene, say, no wala, we go tell them go they report here every day. You go tell parents say you don't see them. When they see them here, they always disappear out here. So we went back to where and told my parents. When did they put this story in my mother look at KBO? You see Ajiri for Lagos, no wala. How much you want? The guys said, just give her a transport for you to go Lagos. Carry me, come back. They give her money, he come. He preach for me. I decide to follow and come back. But I still come out again. Now, last year, my man did my ass. With a gist the matter. Now, my man say, you really serious? Say, Kabiru see for Oshodi. Now, tell my man say, okay, I will drive you, go here, Kabiru for see me. And my man say, now, today I start to believe. Say, don't be coming, you carry your own commands. It's that funny. I just came to Lagos and I started sleeping under the bridge, not sure.
Wow.
That was how I entered bus conducting now.
Wow.
Then, no, say, bus stop boys, they do conduct. So, you see, there are defined conductor, you know, so then you walk. So, and I went to Mushi. Now, instead of getting a bus that runs Mushi, no Shudi, I found a bus that runs on Latitude to Palm Avenue. If you know Mushi well, you know Latitude to Palm Avenue. So, I started walking on Latitude to Palm Avenue. The whole of Domingo has in Coca, Mashalashi. So that route, I was there for a while. Then I met a man called Demola. He drives a bus on that route. Quite of these fine boy drivers. He's not the last type. In the always they wear clean clothes. They wear. So I got close to him. He was living at Kitu, Alakbere. Bako bus stop, number 2 Salami Giwa. He was the one I was now working with that said I should come and start living.
Hey.
That was how my journey at Salami Giwa Street started. Now you know me as Princewill. If you go to Salami Giwa today, everybody knows me as Bruno. That's what they call me.
Oh, Bruno Mars.
Yeah, that's what they call me, Bruno. So call me Jibulo. Some call me Bulldog. You know, when I came to Lagos, I knew if I tell them my real name, they go destroy us. So I don't find one name. Give them. Till today, people still live in that compound.
No, my God.
Till today, I still have a good working relationship with Demola. You know, so it was during the course of that working, we now moved from Palm Avenue and started running Ojuelegba Pango, Ojuelegba Ikeja. Sometimes we run Oshodi to Yanapaja, Super Ilepo, then if Sangufo, and turn at Sangufo. So that was how we started working those routes. Now, from inside those buses, night passengers, they say, if I don't collect my money finish like this, now full comedy show. You know, people were just laughing. In my head, I wasn't doing comedy, but the passengers felt I was doing comedy. So one day, I carried two comedians, Emeka Smith and MC Pato. That time, there's a place called Planet One in Maryland.
I know Planet
where
One.
Yeah, you have this filling station now. There was Planet One there. Project Fame was being recorded in Planet One by Ultima Studios. So Emeka Smith and MC Pato were coming from Planet One. And I carried them at Maryland bus stop. So they were talking comedy and I asked for their number. So Emeka gave me his card. It was Emeka and I called that I'm funny. So Emeka said, I should come. Took me to a wedding at Tony Street in Kenya. I don't know I take a hat, carry what you see for bus, go wedding.
Yeah. He said, don't hear you now.
Yeah, you know, but I don't fit. I bought a black cordial pant trouser and orange shirt. I know they forget and I went for the wedding. I tell her, I won't perform. Give me mic, my perform for people wedding. After that, he now told me to come for a Wise Open Mic Night. Me, I don't even define AY myself before. I'd watched him on TV at the time that he worships with the Household of God Church, Reverend Chris Okotie, at Oregon. So I looked for Household of God Church and I went there. At that time, AY doesn't even come there anymore. But they invite him once on occasion. So one of those occasions, he now came.
And he saw you.
And he saw me. That was about the same time Emeka Smith had told me to come for AY's Open Mic. So I collected his card too. I know they forget that number, 3222444. That is first number that year. So I called him. Anyway, I said, all this worry, but so I don't come. Every time when I phone him, come open mic night, come open mic night. So I went to open mic night. Form was 3,000 at the National Theatre, Surulere. We are about 100 contestants.
Wow.
They audited 15 of us and brought us for the main show. That competition had me, a cappella, Ebobom, youngest landlord.
A cappella?
Yes.
Wow.
I was second, a cappella was first. Then had Wilmouth. I had a lot of people, but I came second. And that was how my name registered as a comedian. So I kept going there. I came out second 7 times in that competition. I never won once. Then the announcement for National Comedy Challenge started. National Comedy Challenge was organized by Opal Williams and sponsored by MTN at the time. So I went for National Comedy Challenge. We were doing 6-7 states. And I went to contest for Lagos State and I won Lagos State. That was how I got into Night of a Thousand Laughs in 2010. That show had me, Agudai, Gordons, Bobby, and Sheila. Then youngest landlord. We were the only 6 comedians there. And that was how I became a comedian.
Wow. Man, your journey is a journey. Firstly,
this is two things.
Anyways, it's still the Upper Room with Pascal and of course Prince Will is here. The Prince Will. The Will and the Prince.
Yes.
I like that. I like it. We want a short break right now. And when we return, the show continues. So stick around and get away. Welcome back, guys. It's still the Upper Room, and of course, I still have with me Princewill here, the Ojiri one.
Let's
talk about the way your personal life actually affected your comedy. In your comedy, do you feel like when you're doing your stand-up comedy, some of the personal things that you've gone through comes into it?
You see, comedy is not just being funny. Comedy can be interesting. Comedy can be what makes people say, wow. Everything put together gives you a wonderful performance. There are types of comedy I can give that nobody can replicate. Because I'm talking from experience. When I tell you about how Davo Driver pay Wolo, the whole U-turn, the whole boys, you know, if I put all these things together, and because I can speak good English, so by the time I switch, I just get attention, you know? So it makes it unique. My background has made comedy for me look effortless. I'm not really cracking jokes most of the time. I'm telling stories the way it's playing in my head. Mm-hmm. And it comes out funny. Mm-hmm. You know, when we are going for auditions of open mic night, eh? I don't know what to say until I get there. I just talk.
So you never practiced any
joke? No, I don't have that time. Now that I know that comedy is a script, now that I started selling shows for yearly performance. Now I have to give a script, I have to rehearse jokes, I have to research. But initially when it started for me, I just talk the way I talk.
How do you think if you're trying to put side by side or just oppose between when you were just talking without researching comedy, would you think gave more of Prince Will?
Okay, it was when I was just talking. But now has
transition.
Yeah, so now I've transitioned, I've grown. So you see, a comedian can be very funny, but might not make money like AY. That's what people don't understand. They think it's about being funny. Until we stand on the stage of First Bank, you will know why they're paying AY 5 million. and they are paying one boy that is very funny 200,000. And this boy is even funny person. I use the boy start the event, you will know the difference. So now I can crack jokes for president. I can talk to governors. It's not I can talk to governors. I talk to governors because now I am more enlightened, more educated, and I'm more mature in the game. But when I was just a young comedian, what I could do was just make people laugh. There's a difference in the both of them.
Mm, I understand. Now talking about the reasons why comedians, you don't really, some of them, you don't hear their names anymore. Yeah. What do you think it is? You think it is the industry that suffocated them or they suffocated themselves?
Okay, so funny enough, the people we think are suffocated are not suffocated. So the industry is funny. There is popular acts, the acts that are popular. Then there is financial acts, the ones that are rich. They are not popular. I don't know if you get me. So there's Sheila is popular, although you get money. There's AY is popular, although you get money. There's Puffy is popular. There are some people that are popular, I don't want to call their name, they're not gonna die. Right? Then there are comedians that are not popular. But now they get all the events within Lagos. Saku, you feel no noir. But you see, it's 1.5 million will be paid, and we do 7 events a month. No story. But it's not popular. In fact, most of your big boys, you know, not see back financially. There are guys like that. They know how to speak the sweet English. They know how to anchor the weddings. They know how to wear suits. They know how to look prim and proper. But they are not the stand-up comedians that you see every day on popular shows. So some people deliberately relegated from being popular to that league. People like T.A. He deliberately told himself, leave popularity first. I want to be the most sought after wedding MC in Nigeria, and he is. People like Ajele. You don't see Ajele on your, you will not hear AY life featuring Ajele, not D. The comedians who get Ajele money for this industry, not reach 7. Say, I know now, all the governors for West Africa, for Southwest Nigeria now. Naim, there's no story about it. Because that side, camera not there, but money there. So the industry is funny.
Camera, the lens look clear.
Now, some comedians decide to own their audience. People like me, right? I am not on your everyday AY life, but I'll do one show a year, right? And I have 400 people that will give me 50,000 naira for tickets. Calculate 50,000 times 400 people. 50,000 times 10 is half a million, times 100 is 5 million, that's 20 million naira. I will do this show with 7 million. And I'll get 13 million naira for one. You that you call yourself a busy comedian, that you are collecting 500,000 naira per event, you will need to do 26.
In a month?
Where you want for doing in a month? You need a full year. I've made it in one show. One. So comedians have looked for their niche. They have found out that this is where I'm good. And they have held it strong. You understand? Some people will focus on skits. The money a Sabinus makes. They're not born any comedian. We be stand-up comedian well. We go saying they make that money from stand-up comedy. You know, sometimes when skit makers buy houses and people say, now only skit that they do, now only him. I'm telling you from experience. I know skit makers who make $30,000, $40,000 every month and they're not popular. No, it's $40,000, $60 million. And they're not popular. So people have entered different zones. Like Anomo Baba. He has left the big stages. But if you see Anomo Baba invoice, if you see the $4 million and the $5 million, when they wire every month, in event, because he's the one that resonates with that audience. That he's the person they trust. Binga the Inca the first. You don't see him on basket mouth shows. But make governor of Lagos State they do events. Go and check with the MC. May they tell you say Tinubu they come Lagos. Go and check with the MC. Do you know how much they pay for those events?
I know. It's crazy. Let's talk about Grace. How Grace worked for you. How's Grace worked for you?
Like I said, If you look at me, I'm not even supposed to see money by motor. The bad character when I get plenty, I don't get respect. I'm very arrogant and stubborn. Or so they say, even if I don't think it is so. But in the matter of two or three witnesses, the truth is established.
Maybe
so
if it's we just have like, the fact that you don't so understand your
if you have history. People who say this is who you are, bro, that's why I am. I'm arrogant, I'm stubborn. I don't listen to people. I do my things the way I want to do it. But a lot of them also say I'm a good person. So I take that as a consolation. That my guys think I'm a wonderful, I'm a good person. Some say I have a good heart, but the one they don't all dispute is that I'm stubborn and not a yeah-word. And I don't like confession.
And you like it?
Yeah, so grace had carried me so far. It had carried me. The level of, the number people have quarreled with in this industry, I'm not supposed to see food shop. But God has said, no, I'll give you yours and it will be yours.
In an interview that happened, I think was last year, I heard the stalker saying that he went to some of the comedians to go and meet them. They declined him. He went to some of them. They said that he had to go and meet this person. He has to go and meet this person where he hosts show. You understand?
We have that and you have it everywhere. Every industry. Nevertheless.
So he's just bluffing?
No, it's not just bluffing. He has that. You have that. There are some gigs. You need your colleagues, right? But trust me, bro, if you trend tomorrow as a stand-up comedian, you see that worry again where you tell people may they pull you since, they'll call you from there. All you need is just to be good and have your clients. I learned that very quick. So Destoka was telling Gordons to put him on worry again. What he did not know is that Gordons could not. Your colleagues go to like say they fit. They're not fit. What they can do for you is recommend you, but if you cannot deliver yourself. There was a time my biggest dream was to be on Glow Laughter Fest. I was fighting to be there. At that time, Glow Laughter Fest was paying $250,000 for a stand-up comedy show. My payment as a comedian was $30,000. You know, so I was fighting. I was working with Sheila. We go all. I couldn't get on stage. Until one day I was performing somewhere. And I met the stage manager, Yinka. I said, put me up on this show now. He said, yeah, come now, we'll use you to pre-show. And I went for pre-show. It wasn't Sheila that put me on the stage. It was my performance at the pre-show. See, you are a comedian, you are funny. You have five people in your family that likes you, seven in your church, two in your compound, nine in your school. You have 20 audience. Hold those 20 audience. When you are doing a show and you are putting a billboard, it's because those 20 people you are putting it. Forget the new audience. Now those ones, they are on your contact list. You have them. They are not just calling you because you have not proven to them. Focus on proving to them. Leave your colleague first. Nobody they call him. See, if I get a call for an event and the client says I have 300,000, I say I won't collect 300,000. He tells you okay. I say let me recommend somebody. He say no, don't worry, I have somebody else in mind. The only time they let me recommend somebody can be 3-4 times a year. Is that what my colleague that is working with me want to bank on? Ah yes, I'll give him one or two. So the best thing he will do for himself is look for his clients himself. So when I started off as a comedian, when I found out that my colleagues not really like me and they not go work, I went back home. I was living in Keto with my six people inside my one room. And I asked myself, do I need Emeka Smith to blow? Emeka Smith is a good person. I'm just trying to tell you how I started. Do I need Emeka Smith to blow? Something said yes. Okay. Who does Emeka Smith need to blow? He needed AY. So who does AY need to blow? He needed Alibaba. So who does Alibaba need to blow? He did it himself.
The mind game, I think. That's it. Smart.
Thank
That's
you
really
so
good,
much.
Man. Thank you so Don't much, Prince Will, for coming through on the show. Make sure you follow us on our social platforms currently displayed on the screen right now. Till we come your way again, give them one party word. Give them one party word.
Till we come your way again, my brother. Also,
thank you so much. We'll see you at the next episode.